we're out here in IWA in Germany, and of course, Air Arms. Had to come by the Air Arms booth and see Claire. We talked to this about SHOT Show, and she was like, you gotta come by our booth in Germany, because you'll get to see everything. It's way bigger, way more dramatic. A lot of pictures of people that aren't me. Next year?
Huh? Maybe.
Just saying. Just throwing it out there. How are you?
We're good, yes.
Yeah?
Good.
Going well?
Very well. This is always a great show for us. It's the biggest show that we do, so it's good to be here.
Isn't it the biggest show in the world?
I think in terms of what we do, yes. But in terms of size against SHOT Show, probably not. Probably not. I think SHOT Show may be bigger.
Really?
Yeah.
You're the first person to say that.
Well, I think because SHOT Show... Am I the first person to
say
that?
Yeah. No, everyone says that this is the biggest one in the world. But I don't know.
It is in terms of our customer base, because we see the majority of our customers here.
Now, that's one of the big differences of SHOT Show and IWA. SHOT Show is for the industry. You have to be in the industry to even get into SHOT Show. This is for consumers. People who just want to, who buy guns, shoot guns, love guns, can just come here and see all the new stuff.
It's just trade. It's just a trade show.
Right.
It's not a public show.
Oh.
Is it not?
I don't know, is it?
No, it's not a public show, is it?
Can consumers come here?
No, it's a trade show.
I made that up. Scratch that entire part, don't use it. Don't use it. So it's a big trade show.
It's going well.
We're nailing it. This is what we do. Most importantly, we're having fun. Okay, so...
Should we keep telling ourselves?
Yeah, of course, of course. So here's so this is it. So IWA... I mean, I've been hearing this is the biggest, because of Europe, especially for air guns, it doesn't get any bigger than this, as far as the amount of air guns, amount of air gun companies, again, the space they take up.
This is the biggest trade show for us, yeah.
Yeah.
In terms of meeting all our customers, I mean, we trade with 45 different countries. Not all at the same time, not every month.
It's really impressive.
But throughout the year, 45 different countries, and this is a good spot to meet up with most of them. So our days are normally crammed with appointments, just re-engaging with our customers and hopefully taking on new ones as well. So
for the people who aren't aware, people out there, our audience, that don't know Air Arms, who is Air Arms in a nutshell?
Well, at Air Arms, we are primarily an engineering company.
Huh?
We fell about getting involved in guns by accident. We started just making component parts for another company. To cut a very long story short, they went bankrupt. We were left with heaps of component parts. It's like, what are we supposed to do with these? There's a lot of money invested in this. So at the time, my father very cleverly done a deal with the receiver, shall we say, bought the rights to the rifle, and we started building and selling them ourselves under the name of our engineering company, which was NSP.
Okay.
So NSP have been around for like 55 years. Mm-hmm. We decided that NSP wasn't very air gun friendly.
Okay, sure.
So we decided to introduce a brand name, and that was Air Arms, and that was registered in 1983.
Okay.
So we've been around a long time.
Yeah.
We're good at what we do. We're precision engineers, and that's our passion, and that's what we do. And over the years, we did a lot of subcontract work for the car industry, the hospital equipment, agricultural equipment, shop fittings.
Really?
Yeah, we put guns
on all those things.
No. But over the years, the guns got bigger and bigger and bigger, and we had to move away from our subcontract work, and all we do now is guns.
And so you guys, I mean, you make a specific amount of guns. You kind of have a few types of guns, and then you just deviate a little bit from there.
In most cases, yes. So we have like the S510 or the S400 main body, and we take that concept because we know that concept works very well, and we build products around that base to suit different target shooting disciplines.
Okay, I know that you're huge in competitions, and we've talked a little bit in the past, and I mean, you can't help but when you walk by it and see this gun, you're like, that's the prettiest gun I've ever seen in my entire life. What is this gun? What is this?
So this is our TS400. And this rifle was designed hand in hand with the British coaches for Target Sprint.
For Target Sprint?
Target Sprint, yeah.
So for those of you who are like, what'd she just say? Exactly. Hold, please. We'll get to target sprint in a second.
So target sprint is about running and shooting. It's a take on the biathlon. So if you're familiar with the biathlon.
Skiing. Stop, shoot.
Guns
come
on
back,
your back.
Prone.
That's okay. It. So the difference being, you don't carry the rifle with you. You leave the rifle on the shooting range. And the idea is that you run 400 meters, you shoot five targets, which is this little baby down here. So
this is just like the one in the Olympics.
No, because the target sprint's not an Olympic discipline.
No, but the target, yeah. Right? The little white paddles, like.
It's very similar. Yeah, it is. It is. Yeah, it's an Olympic target. Yes.
Okay.
And we make those specifically for target sprint.
Okay.
So with target sprint, you run 400 meters, you knock down five targets, you run 400, knock down five targets, and you finish on a 400 meter run. And you, my friend, are going to give that a go when you come to the UK.
That sounds absolutely miserable. I haven't run.
Got running shoes?
I haven't run 400 meters since I was in junior high, and I ran the 800 meter. Dash, yeah. They called it. I thought it was long distance, right? I came out and jogged and everything sprung. I'm like, what's happening?
There you go.
Okay, so you got, so this is for competitive people who
highly
want to do a little bit more with their shooting, make it a sport, make it something that's active.
Do you know, I think for us, what's really promising about this particular discipline, and I'm talking to a few guys in the USA now because we really need to bring this sport to the UA. UA? We really need to bring this sport to the USA.
University of America. It's a new school.
Yeah, there you go. Because it is about discipline. It's about fitness. It's about focus. It's about community. It's about, you know, being part of something. And this has grown, this particular sport has grown so fast in the UK. It's incredible.
Really?
So fast.
So how can I do this? When can I, how do I do this?
How do you do this?
You want me to come to the UK and do this?
You're coming to the UK. I'm going to take you to the GB Squad's training circuit, and you're going to give it a go. And our athletes will tell you and teach you exactly all you need to know. It'll be fun. Just make sure you got your trainers.
The boots aren't going to work.
The boots
and don't wear camo.
You can wear camo if you want.
Okay.
We'll still see you.
Yeah, good. Do you have this in like a paisley?
No, this is a this is a special wrap version, but of course it is available in the standard NPR popular stock.
I mean, yeah. I would definitely want this one.
You want this one? You want to use this one?
Oh, 100%.
We'll bring this one then. You can use this one. Yeah.
Okay.
So the difference between this and the standard NPR, now the NPR is a 10-meter sporter rifle, is the cocking mechanism.
Okay.
And this cocking mechanism is all about speed. So it's a push and a pull rather than a bolt action.
Right.
We'll see on the rifle over there.
So this is genuinely a race. I mean, it's a race.
Oh my God, yeah. The youngsters are so competitive. It just like, I can't watch it anymore because I feel like I'm going to have a heart attack.
What happens if you miss? Do you have to run extra?
No, so if you miss, you only have so many shots that you can use.
Okay.
And if you use all your pellets and you haven't knocked all your targets down, you get a time penalty.
Okay.
So it's, the good thing about this particular sport is such a spectator sport, because as with any athletics sort of discipline, you're there cheering your favorite athlete on. And it's really,
what do they wear, like a onesie or something? The really short shorts?
They may wear short shorts.
I don't wear the tiny shorts, do I?
You can wear whatever shorts you want.
Okay.
You can wear paisley shorts.
I'm gonna wear high socks and I'm gonna do it right. All right. Okay.
We're gonna try this.
Deal.
I'll come to the UK to do it. Yeah, do it. Excellent.
Done.
Right.
I want to talk about this again. We're moving down here because there's some big news that just has recently happened here for this gun right here. Now tell me about, this is a gun that I was introduced to at SHOT Show.
Yes.
And it's already won Gun of the Year?
Already won Air Gun of the Year, 2019.
Air Gun of the Year.
Voted for by the public. So we were super thrilled, really shocked, because, you know, competition's tough out there. There's a lot of good product out there.
Sure.
And so for us to have won this award, voted for by the British public, was really quite
Well, congratulations.
Quite an honor. Thank you.
So this is the S510 Sporter, right? This is like more the hunting.
This is the ultimate sporter.
Ultimate sporter.
Yeah.
And why is it, what's ultimate about it?
Because it's got adjustability in the cheek piece and the butt hook. So I think, again, we were probably one of the first people, first companies to introduce adjustability into a sporting stock. Because generally, sporting stocks are a solid piece.
Sure.
And we thought, you know what? With the experience and knowledge that we've gained in our target shooting disciplines, it's like, well, why shouldn't a sporter have the same adjustability as a target stock?
Yeah.
Hence the reason it's the ultimate sporter.
I mean, you guys, very classic look with a lot of your guns, very, and you don't really deviate much from, like, it's like you know what you do it well, and you just kind of stick with it.
Yeah, I mean, this type of business model that we have has always proved very successful for us. You know, we are not about the hard sell.
Yeah.
We're about promoting and supporting the shooting disciplines, because without those, then we all might as well all pack up and go home.
Right.
So we support and we sponsor and we give a lot back to our industry and our sport, because it's important to us and it means a great deal to us. And we're all very, very passionate about what we do. So you can't say you're passionate about something and not do anything about it. So
fair enough.
We practice what we preach, we do what we say we're going to do, and yeah.
Looking at all your guns going online, I mean, this is awesome. I've recently got one of these sent to me. I believe you sent it, but I haven't actually had a chance to shoot it yet because it just came out, and now it's going to be here. Very exciting stuff.
Very.
Those are those seem like two things that are kind of different.
Current.
Yeah, very current, very kind of newer. But as we kind of look through AirArms, you guys, why? When I talk to you and I talk about all the different guns and what people are doing with guns, there's such a big deviation of, you are very focused, like you said, on the shooting sports, on the disciplines, because they're in the, especially in the UK, field target. But a lot of people know that even like there's Olympic shooting that is very popular that maybe a lot of Americans don't even really know that are air guns.
Well, I don't think, we don't go into the top level Olympic shooting disciplines, but what we do offer is entry level, and this would be our entry level 10 meter range. Mm-hmm. We haven't quite made that step into top notch precision 10 meter or 50 meter precision shooting rifles, but never say never, my friend.
Well, right, because that's your world. I mean, you guys, there's just not a lot of people that are talking about this. Like, there's not a lot of other manufacturers that are really talking about.
No, and I think the big players, Anschutz, Steyr, you know, they dominate the market, and I think they dominate it very well.
And those guns cost $1 billion.
Absolutely.
And they're very expensive. Yeah.
But where we excel is like the field target shooting disciplines, like hunter field target. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with that yet, but field target, definitely. Mm-hmm. Field target. And we offer, I think it's because we diversify a lot. We offer products for a lot of different shooting disciplines.
Yeah.
We don't just concentrate on target. We don't just concentrate on sporting.
Right.
We try to offer everything for a whole range.
So, I mean, look at this wall. I mean, from the competitions, we've kind of moved past, but then as you get into these, even some of these, and this kind of like really gets away from anything you guys have ever done, but this was, again, launched earlier this year.
It was.
This tactical version.
Yeah.
So you can find anything that anybody really wants out of air guns you guys offer.
We try to. I'm not suggesting we do it all, but we try. We try and listen to the demands of the consumer, hence the reason we introduced a Galahad. Now, I would say
the bullpups.
The bullpup for us was the unwanted love child.
Really?
May I say. That we all grew to love.
Poor once, Galahad.
Once it was born, Sir Galahad. Yeah.
I always think of Monty Python with the coconuts. That's all I can ever think of.
Gotta do that.
If I could sing the song right now, I would. It's been a while since I've seen it.
Again, that was just due to consumer demand, actually.
Right.
We wouldn't have ordinarily created something like that because it doesn't really fit with what we do and what we're about. But do you know, actually, once we created it and once we got into the project, we actually fell in love with it. So, and it's a cracking little rifle. Even I can shoot that one, girls and guys.
There you go. It's nice, it's small, it's compact, and it's accurate. We reviewed it, and it's a fun gun.
Yeah, it is a fun gun.
All right, well, I need to find out more about the competition stuff that you guys do. I mean, Air Arms is a part of American Air Gunner. They're one of our partners, one of our family members. So for us to be family, I need to know more about what you do. So I'm going to come and do all the competitions.
Yeah.
Probably fail miserably, but I'll be in a onesie, so that'd be great.
What is with the onesie?
I don't know. That's what, like, track people. They wear the sprinters.
You can wear your camo for Phil Target or HFT.
Yeah, it makes more sense. Yeah. Should probably do that. All right, I'm gonna come out and.
I would pay money to see him in a onesie.
Not good money. That would not be. You'd be like, oh gosh, put back on the camo. There's a reason for the camo. It hides a lot.
There you go.
A lot. Claire, thank you.
You're very welcome. This has been fun.
It's good to get a history of where you guys come from and what you're pushing for. Because tell me this, like, where would you like to see the air gun industry go in, like, the next, you know, 5 to 10 years?
I'd like to see the air gun industry continue to grow. I think in the UK especially, anything to do with shooting is a dirty word. And anything we can do to promote the positive sides of air gun shooting has got to be a good thing. I think the key point is to try and bring more people into shooting that aren't shooting already. And we also offer that by providing a platform called the Air Arms Experience, which we can talk about when you're in the UK.
Sure.
And it takes all our shooting disciplines to the general public so that they can try a discipline that they may never have tried before. Mm. And I think as a result of that, we've seen growth. We've seen new growth coming into the UK with people wanting to shoot air guns. And if we can take that business model or that model and duplicate that throughout the rest of the world, I think we stand a good chance of ensuring that our industry continues. And that's what it's about at the end of the day.
There you go. I have one more question for you. Target Sprint.
Yeah.
Is this your idea?
That's playing on your mind.
It really is. Was this your idea?
It's not my idea.
This isn't something you created?
It's not something I created. No.
Okay. Like, you're not just joking with me. This is actually, you're not just going to have me run around and then shoot guns and then laugh at me.
Actually, in Europe, they've been practicing Target Sprint for a number of years, particularly in Germany, actually, because they use it as part of their summer training program for the biathlon, which is a winter sport, right?
Okay.
So fairly recently, a couple of years ago, it became an ISSF discipline. Mm-hmm. And since then, many, many countries have got on board and involved. And how we got involved through British Shooting, and British Shooting is the home to our Olympic athletes.
Right.
They approached us and said, look, we want to get involved in this. How can we do it? This is the potential. And it was like, let's do it. This is where we want to be. And we've supported them from day one. And as I say, the growth, actually giving them the ability to grow the sport was key. Mm-hmm. Because what we did is we supported them with product. They took that product up and down the country, showcasing what the discipline was about.
Yeah.
And from that, people were signing up almost on a daily basis, wanting to get involved. Our kids are so competitive.
It sounds like it.
Yeah.
Well, maybe this is fun.
It's so fun.
Is it?
It's fun for
the viewer. Have you done it?
It's fun for the viewer. I can't run. I'm too old to run.
Oh, stop. We're going to see, because if I do it, you know who's doing it with me? Game on, ladies and gentlemen.
I know what's involved, so it's a no from me.
Exactly. All right, we got more coming from IWA. Stay with us. Claire, thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Very interesting.